To BrainBuzz Academy. Myself, Umia Salma. Today we will be dealing with 28 February 2020 current affairs. As you have known, we will be dealing with everyday current affairs. Today our topic is 28 February 2020 current affairs. If you are new to BrainBuzz Academy, here we provide you current affairs for SSCs, railways, bank exams, and other state PSUs and UPSC as well. See, if you are a student who is preparing from APPSC or TSPSC, you can read the current affairs in Telugu medium too, right? Okay, let me tell you, BrainBuzz Academy also has a YouTube channel where you can find everyday notifications, current affairs, general awareness, and other exam-related subjects, right? Now, not wasting your time, let us go directly into the current affairs, right? Today's lesson is 2020 current affairs. Okay, sorry, 28 February current affairs. The first topic is Atal Innovation Mission partnered with NASCOM to launch all-based module in 5000 ATLs. See, this is the logo of Atal Innovation Mission. Atal Innovation Mission. It is sponsored by Niti Aayog. Okay, now let us discuss briefly about what is Atal Innovation Mission and why it has been partnered with NASCOM to launch artificial intelligence based module in 5000 ATLs. That is right. Let us discuss briefly. See here, NITI, that means National Institute for Transforming India, Aayog's Atal Innovation Mission, AIM, has collaborated with NASCOM, that is National Association of Software and Services Companies, to launch the artificial intelligence based module, including artificial intelligence kits across 5000 Atal tinkering labs for the beneficial of 2.5 million students in the country from February 27, 2020, so that the students can get for better knowledge of artificial intelligence. Additionally, an artificial intelligence setup module is under development that is be launched next step. Right? Even in the last class current affairs, we have discussed about the artificial intelligence. So there is more probability that the question may be asked in the exam about the artificial intelligence and the partnerships that has been made for the development of artificial intelligence, right? So, okay, next come. This curriculum will make available technologies to school students from one of the top partner companies, including Adobe, SAP Labs, Microsoft, Wipro, and NASCOM, among others. Right? This is about Atal Innovation Mission partnership with NASCOM for artificial intelligence modules. Right? The next topic is International Conference on Standardization of Diagnosis and Terminologies in Ayurveda, Unani, and Siddha Systems of Medicine. That is ICO SGI TAUS 2020, which is held in New Delhi. So this is the logo of ICO SGTIUS 2020, right? This has been held in 25th to 26th February 2020 at New Delhi. These three are the logos of Ayurveda, Unani, and Siddha Systems of Medicine, right? Now let us discuss briefly about this topic. See here, this is the two-day international conference on standardization of diagnosis and terminologies in Ayurveda, Unani, and Siddha Systems of Medicine, that is ICO SGITAUS 2020, which was held in New Delhi on February 25, 26, 2020. This is the biggest ever international conference on standardization of diagnosis and terminologies of traditional medicine. It was organized by Ministry of Ayurveda, Yoga and Naturopathy, Unani, right? And Siddha, Sovarigpa and Homeopathy, which is also Ayush, in association with World Health Organization, WHO, at the ministerial level. The objective of this conference was to underline the power of traditional medicine, that is TM, systems and their significance in addressing the public health challenges of the 21st century. See, the participants of ICO SGI TAUS 2020 are Mostly 16 countries has been participated. There may be a question like how many countries has been participated in the international conference which has conducted on standardization of diagnosis and terminologies in Ayurveda, Unani and Siddha systems of medicine. Then the answer should be 16. There may be a question like which country has been participated or which has not been participated, and the options are given. So we need to remember the number of countries participated as well as the name of each country, right? So here we see Sri Lanka, Mauritius, Serbia, Curaçao, Cuba, Myanmar, Equatorial Guinea, Qatar, Ghana, Bhutan, Uzbekistan, India, Switzerland, Iran, Jamaica, and Japan, right? These are the 16 countries which has participated in International Conference on Standardization of Diagnosis and Terminologies in Ayurveda, Unani, and Siddha Systems of Medicine, right? The next topic is NCAER releases India's first NCAER Land Records and Services Index 2020, in which Madhya Pradesh emerges as top performer, Ladakh at the bottom, right? Now let us detail what is NCAER, right? See, this is the NCAER logo where the NCAER Land Record and Service Index has been displayed. It has been formed since 1956. Quality, relevance, impact. The logo of this is in India map as well as quality, relevance, impact. Now let us see the rankings of each state and union territory. Here, Madhya Pradesh stands at the top of 74.9% of NLRSI, that means Land Record and Services Index Tax. Okay, here, Ladakh stays at the bottom, right? Now, let us discuss about what is NCAER, right? On February 27, 2020, according to the first edition of NCAER, Land Records and Service Index, NLRSI 2019 to 2020, released by the National Council of Applied Economic Research, that means NCAER, National Council of Applied Economic Research, Madhya Pradesh, MP has emerged as the best performing state in terms of digitizing land records with the score of 74.9%, whereas it was followed by Odisha with 67.5 points and Maharashtra 65.3 points. That means on the table given, here we see on the top place Madhya Pradesh with 74.9%, and then Odisha 67.5%, and then Maharashtra 65.3%, right? And the bottom ranking was Ladakh. That means there is no digitalization. There is a very less digitalization took place on the Land and Services Index tax, right? So here, while Union Territory of Ladakh ranked at the bottom of 33rd position with a score of just 2.0, whereas Madhya Pradesh scored 74.9%, Odisha 67.5%, Maharashtra 65.3%, but Ladakh scored just 2.0%, right? The next, about the next topic, right? This is Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana. This is the logo of, this is Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana. Here, government approved 32 projects under Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana, PMKSY. Right? Here you can confuse with another PMKSY also, right? This is another one, that is another one, that is Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sujay Yojana, right? Now let us discuss in detail how many projects have been, that means 32 projects. Let us discuss detailly about 32 projects, right? On Feb 27, 2020, government approved a total of 32 projects under unit scheme of Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana PMKSY scheme for agro marine processing and development of agro processing clusters. In the meeting of Interministerial Approval Committee, IMAC, presided over by Union Minister of Food Processing Industries, MOFPI, that is Harsmirat Kaur Badal, the project covers about 17 states, leveraging an investment worth ₹406 crores, right? The main objective of this project is the of the scheme is creation of processing and preservation capacities and modernization of existing food processing units to increase the level of processing and value addition leading to reduction of wastage, right? This is about the 32 projects which are under the scheme of Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana. Right? The next one is diplomat Abhishek Singh appointed as the next ambassador of India to Venezuela. Okay. On February 27, 2020, the Ministry of External Affairs, Government of India, appointed diplomat Sri Abhishek Singh as the next ambassador of India to Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela. He will succeed Raju Kumar Napal, who passed away recently. Right? Just remember this point, because Raju Kumar Napal passed away recently, then Abhishek Singh has become the ambassador of India to the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela. So there may be a question that who is the former, right? Who is the former ambassador of India to Venezuela or the current ambassador of India to Venezuela, right? Let us discuss about who is Abhishek Singh, right? Abhishek Singh is a 2003 batch Indian Foreign Services IFS officer currently serving as deputy chief of mission at Embassy of India in Kabul, Afghanistan. Right? About Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela, the capital is Caracas. Caracas currency is Petro Bolivar Soberano, and the president is Juan Gerardo Guaido Marquez. Right? This is about Abhishek Singh as well as the Venezuela, Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela. The next topic is Union Minister of Defense Sri Rajnath Singh inaugurated new light combat helicopter LCH production hangar at HAL complex in Bengaluru. Right? Here we can see the pic of Rajnath Singh with other Air Force colleagues, where he opened and inaugurated a new light combat helicopter HCH production hangar at Hindustan Aeronautic Limited complex in Bengaluru, right? Here, we see detail about it. On Feb 27, 2020, Union Defense Minister Sri Rajnath Singh inaugurated the new light combat helicopter LCH production hangar at Hindustan Aeronautic Limited HAL complex in Bengaluru, Karnataka. LCH is designed and developed by HAL, that is Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, a defense public sector undertaking about LCH. That is, LCH is a 5.5 ton class combat helicopter powered by two Shakti engines. It has many technical features like advanced light helicopter, namely sleek and narrow fuselage, tricycle crashworthy landing gear, and there are many other points which related to LCH, right? This is the next topic, that is 6th Offshore Patrol Vessel Yard 45006 Vajra launched in Chennai. This is the picture which shows the where Vajra has been launched. It has been launched in Chennai with the partnership of L&T, that is Larsen and Toubro, right? Here, on February 27, 6th Offshore Patrol Vessel OPV Yard 45006 Vajra was launched to enhance coastal security in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. Sri Manshukh Lakshman Bhai Mandavia, Minister of State for Shipping, IC and Chemicals and Fertilizers, is the chief guest of launching ceremony. The 6th vessel in the series of 7 OPV, that is Offshore Patrol Vessel, is designed and developed by Larsen and Toubro under the central government's initiative Make in India. So, the objective of 6th Offshore Patrol Vessel is to strengthen the efforts of Indian Coast Guard. Right? Okay, coming to next topic, that is, again, Larsen and Toubro builds 5th Offshore Patrol Vessel called ICGS Virad, commissioned in Chennai, Tamil Nadu, for Indian Coast Guard. The first one is Vajra and this is Varad. So don't confuse with two names, as both start with V, right? Now let's go directly into what is Varad, right? On Feb 28, 2020, Indian Coast Guard 19 meter long Fifth offshore petrol vessel called ICGS Varad was introduced into the service by Sri Manchuk Mandavia, the Union Minister of State for Shipping, Independent Charge and Union Minister of State for Chemicals and Fertilizers at LOT Kattupalli Shipyard near Chennai, Tamil Nadu. The vessel has been designed and built by L&T, that is Larsen & Toubro Limited. With ICGS Varad's induction, the ICG will now have 147 ships and boats and 62 aircrafts. The vessel is equipped with 30mm and 12.7mm guns and has special onboard features like the integrated bridge system, platform management system, automated power management system, and high power external firefighting system. See, the vessel also has the capability of to carry four high-speed boats and a twin-engine helicopter for search and rescue operations and law enforcement and maritime patrol. Right? It can also took up pollution response equipment in case of an oil spill in the sea. Right? This is about ICGS Varad, that is offshore petrol vessel. So, in this topic, we have discussed about two offshore petrol vessels, that is Varad as well as Varda. Right. The next topic is Heniguas Salma Nicola, first ever animal that can survive without oxygen, discovered by scientists from Tel Aviv University, that is TAU. Right. This is the picture of Heniguas Salma Nicola. This is the first ever animal that can survive without oxygen. Right. So let us discussing about it. On Feb 26, 2020, researchers at Tel Aviv University, TAU, Israel have discovered a jellyfish-like parasite, Heniguas Salma Nicola, without a mitochondrial genome. The first multicellular organism known to have these options. Okay, this means it does not breathe and lives its lives completely free of oxygen dependency. The study has been published in the Journal Proceedings of National Academy of Sciences. The finding was led by Professor Dorothy Hukan of the School of Zoology at TAU's Faculty of Life Sciences and Steinhardt Museum of National History. It is a part of same family as jellyfish, coral and anemones. The key points of this fish are it is less than 10-celled parasite and lives within the muscle tissue of salmon fish. It is a parasite. Remember, it is a 10-celled parasite, right? And it belongs to the family of jellyfish, coral, and anemones, and lives within the muscle tissue of salmon fish. So, it causes milky flesh or tapioca disease in the fish. It's not yet clear to us that below the parasite generates energy. The mitochondria is the powerhouse of cell where oxygen is captured to make energy. So its absence indicate that the animal was not breathing oxygen. So this is a salmon fish where in this the parasite lives. The name of this parasite is Heniguas Salma Nicola. So that means it lives without oxygen because mitochondria is absent here, where mitochondria is power generation, right? So the next topic is Sanitarian Vedic scholar and Kannada Rajyotsava awardee Pandit Sudhakar Chaturvedi passed away at the age of 122. Right? Let us discuss who is Pandit Sudhakar Chaturvedi. Right? On Feb 27, 2020, Sudhakar Krishna Rao, sanitarian Vedic scholar and freedom fighter, passed away at the age of 122 in Bengaluru, Karnataka. He was born on April 1897 at Balepit, Bengaluru. He was the founding editor of Vedanta magazine devoted to Vedic studies. He was given the title Pandit Sudhakar Chaturvedi for his authority on all the four Vedas. Pandit Sudhakar Chaturvedi for his authority over the all four Vedas. Right? The next about Chaturvedi. Chaturvedi, he was closely associated with Mahatma Gandhi during the freedom struggle and later the Arya Samaj movement. Chaturvedi was a title given to him for his mastery over the four Vedas. He was also called Gandhi's postman as he delivered the letters dictated by Gandhi addressed to the Viceroy of Governor General, and Gandhi called him Karnataki. He was also the eyewitness of 1999 Jallianwala Bagh massacre and many independence movements. So, the next topic is National Science Day, which was observed on Feb 28, 2020, on the birthday of C.V. Raman. These are the tributes to C.V. Raman, where we will be celebrating National Science Day on every year, Feb 28, 2020, right? Coming to the National Science Day, it was observed all over India on Feb 28, 2020. This day makes the discovery of Raman effect by Indian physicist Sir Chandrasekhar Venkata Raman, also called Sir C.V. Raman, on 28 February 1928, for which he was awarded the Nobel Prize in 1930. In 1986, the Government of India declared February 28th as National Science Day. Theme of National Science Day 2020 is Women in Science. The key points are, on this celebration, President Ramnath Kovind presented several awards for science communicators and women scientists at the function held in Vijaya Bhavan, Delhi. This day aims at spreading the message about the importance of science or our daily life efforts and achievements in the field of science for human welfare. So these are about the topics of 28th Feb 2020. In the next class, we will be dealing with 29th February current affairs. Right? This is all about this lesson. Thank you.